students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our science session. So in today's science session, we are going to start our new lesson and the name of the lesson is Light, Shadow and Reflection. Okay, so what is mean by light, how the shadow forms and what is mean by the reflection? All these basic concepts we are going to discuss in this lesson. And again I will repeat the name of the lesson, that is what? Light, Shadows and Reflection. Okay. So dear students, if you have observed or if you have seen that what happens when there will be the night, okay, and when we enter into the dark room, then is it we are able to see all the things? What you will give the answer? Yes, what? We cannot see the things, okay. Why we cannot see the things? Because there is absence of light. So because of the light, we can see the different things or we can observe the different things. So the main or the essential factor to observe the different things, to see the different object, is that what? Light. The presence of light is very important to see the different objects. Okay. So let's move on to the first point from the lesson, that is we'll discuss about the sources of light. So what is meant by the sources of light? So the object which gives us light, that objects are called as what? Sources of light. Okay. Again, I will repeat, what is meant by the sources of light? The object which gives us light, okay, the objects which gives us light, that objects are called as sources of light. So, on the basis of the man-made and the nature, these sources of objects again get classified, okay. So, basically there are the two classifications of the sources of light, that are natural sources of light and human-made sources of light, okay. So, there are the two types of the sources of objects, we can say that, and that is what? Natural sources of light and human-made sources of light. So let's discuss about the first one, natural sources of light. Now natural sources of light means what? The objects, okay, or the sources of light which occurs in nature, that sources of light are called as what? Natural sources of light. The sources of light which are present in nature, which occurs in nature, that sources of light are called as natural sources of light. For example, we can say that sun, star, okay, all these are the examples of natural sources of light. Also, we can add one more example in these natural sources of light, the fireflies that we can see during the night. Okay, so all these are the examples of what? Natural sources of light. Next one, we will move for the next classification, that is human-made sources of light. Now, what is the human-made sources of light? So, the sources of light which are made by human, which are artificial, which are made by human being, that sources of light are called as what? Human-made sources of light. So, we will get numerous examples of the human-made sources of light. We can say that electric bulb, tube light is also there, candle is there, different lamps we are using, okay. All these are the examples of different batteries, torch we are using. All these are the examples of what? Human-made sources of light. Okay. So, sources of light means what? The object which gives us light, they are called as what? Sources of light. Two types of the objects are found, that are natural sources of light and human-made sources of light. Okay. Next one, there is the classification, or all the objects are getting divided into two types, that are luminous and non-luminous objects. Okay, the objects are getting broadly classified into two types, that are luminous objects and non-luminous objects. Now let's discuss what is meant by the luminous object and what is meant by non-luminous object. First we'll go through the luminous object. Now luminous object means what? The objects which has its own light, or the objects which, an object which gives out its own light, that objects are called as what? Luminous object. Okay, what is meant by the luminous object? An object which gives out its own light, means the objects are having its own light, and then that they are reflecting that light, they are called as what? Luminous object. Again, here examples we can give, that what? Sun is there, star is there, torch, candle, lamp, bulb, tube light, or whatever the object which gives us light, that all the objects comes under what? Luminous object. Okay, what? Luminous object. Now next one, we'll discuss about the non-luminous object. Okay, now what is meant by the non-luminous object? An object which does not give out its own light. Okay, an object and it doesn't give any light, that type of the objects are called as what? Non-luminous object. For example, we can say that animals, human beings, this board, okay? Or we can say that pen, pencil, paper, all fan, this wall, or so many things are there which doesn't have its own light, and that objects are called as what? Non-luminous object. So the thing is that if the non-luminous object doesn't give the light, then how we can see them? How we can observe them? Yes, there is one reason for that. So this non-luminous object doesn't have its own light, but they reflect the light which falls on it. Okay, and that reflected light reach to our eyes, and then we can observe that particular object. Okay. For example, we can say that moon. Okay. So the moon doesn't have its own light. The moon reflects the light of the sun. Okay. Means moon gets the light from the sun, and that sun rays they reflect it, and that is the reason we can see the moon. Okay. So the moon doesn't have its own light. The moon is a non-luminous object. It doesn't have its own light. Okay. So this is all about what? Luminous and non-luminous object. Okay, so now let's move on to the next point. Now we will discuss about the transparent, translucent and opaque material. About this concept already we have discussed in our previous lesson, but let's see again how this transparent, translucent and opaque material helps to observe the different things. Okay, first we will go through the transparent material. Now what is the transparent material? So the material which allows the all the light rays to pass through it. Okay, the material which allows all the light rays to pass through it, that type of the material is called as what? Transparent material. That type of the material is called as transparent material. What is my transparent material? The material which allows the light rays to pass through it, completely pass through it, that type of the materials are called transparent materials. For example, we can see that what? Glass, plain glass is the clear glass, clean air, cellophane paper and clean water. All these are what? Transparent material. Transparent material is what? Through which we can see very clearly. Why it can be that we can see very clearly? Because they can transfer all that light rays through it. That's why through the transparent material we can see clearly. Okay. Next one we move for translucent material. Now what is meant by translucent material? So the material which does not allow the light rays, means the all the light rays does not get passed through it, only the some light rays can pass through it, that type of the material are called as translucent materials. Okay. Again, I will repeat what is meant translucent material. The material which allow only to certain light rays to pass through it, only the some light rays to pass through it, that type of the light, that type of the material is called as what? Translucent material. For example, we can say that grounded glass is there, also butter paper is there and tissue paper. Through them we cannot see the clearly. We can see, but clearly we cannot see the through the translucent material. Now we'll see the next one and the last one type of the material, that is opaque. Okay. Now what is mean by opaque? So the material which does not allow the light ray to pass through it. Here see, I have drawn the diagram. The material which does not allow the light rays to pass through it, that type of the material is called as what? Opaque material. That type of the material is called as opaque material. So that through that opaque material we cannot see anything. Okay, through the opaque material we cannot see anything. Now see, this is what? Duster. If I put this duster in front of my eyes, then I can see the things which are present in front of me? No. Why? Because this duster is a opaque material. It does not allow the light rays to pass through it, and that is the reason through this opaque material we cannot see anything. But if we talk about transparent material, for example, we take the glass. Okay. So in that glass, if we put anything, glass, if different types of the objects are there which are made up of glass. If we take the glass bowl and if you put in that ice cream, then that ice cream we can see clearly. Yes, we can see. Why? Because the glass is what? Transparent material. That grounded glass are there which are we are using for the windows. Through that grounded glass we cannot see clearly, because that grounded glass are what? translucent material. Okay, so these are the three types of the material: transparent, translucent, and opaque. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the sources of light. Also, we have discussed about luminous and non-luminous object, and also we have discussed about transparent, translucent, and opaque material. Okay, so this is all about today. This is the time to tell you goodbye. We will meet in the next video with the next point. And for today, thank you.